This is where I found the Gran Turismo racing wheel for $15 in the box. Yeah, we'll see what they have. Usually they don't have anything much in the showcases, but we'll see what they have at the back. I haven't found too many, too much in the terms of games, but we'll see. All right. Guys, I just got off from school. The teacher I had didn't have a class the last period, so I got to get leave a little early today. So I'm going to use this opportunity to go to the Goodwill. Hit it a little earlier and see what we got. Oh, what a cute little doogie in there. He's right here. Can you see him? There he is. So cute. Goodwill didn't have much today. Thought about buying the Tetris thing, but yeah, they're going for like maybe $10, and I've got Tetris, so I'll go to the next one. All right, Goodwill, what have you got for me today? Shall soon find out. wasn't pleasant
either.
First, I thought they got rid of all the, I was just here last week. And I thought they got rid of the whole bin for the DVDs. They just moved it in a really weird spot. Before, it made sense to put it up at the front where all the counters and registers were. Now they've put it in between clothing aisles, which is very strange. I don't know what the Goodwill's doing. And then, on top of that, I saw this GameCube power cord the other day. I thought about getting it for $1.25. I'm like, why not? But then I'm like, you know, I didn't want to. It's like, why, really? Why would I buy it? I mean, I've got a couple GameCubes and I don't need a power cord. Well, I went in there today. It's still there, but now they've, because there's two pieces to the GameCube, what they've done now is priced both pieces of the GameCube to $1.25 each. So now it's double the price because you'd have to buy both pieces of the cord. I don't know what the Goodwill's doing. They don't either. They really don't. And that woman that was overcharged me the other day, she was there again. I'm starting to not like this Goodwill. I think I might hit maybe one or two more. Goodwill number 4. This is the one that closes early. I guess we'll see what they got. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. The store that will save me. It has the games, I am sure. It will have epicness. Pure, unadulterated epicness within these walls, and for a decent price. Go see what's there. Alright guys, I just went to the Goodwill near me after eating a Sunday brunch. And it is a Sunday, I want to make that clear. I went to the Goodwill and usually I wouldn't think you would find much on a Sunday because it's been heavily picked over on the weekends. But not today. Found some PS2 games, couple DS games, a couple PC games, and pretty cool. Alright, so let's start off with some of them. I don't know why I necessarily got these, but they, you know, I find DS games, they were worth like $7 to $10, but we got Hello Kitty Party. Alright, complete. That back out on the shelves, they would steal them for sure. Jerry was doing a service for them by buying them. Next one up, Hello Kitty Daily. I'm sure these are awesome games, by the way. I can't wait to get my Hello Kitty on. And then, this was a pretty good one. I mean, it would have been a bit better if it was for Xbox, but still a nice find. Star Wars Battlefront 2 for the PS2, like a $13 game, complete, and every disc is mint. Every disc is mint. I just could not pass them. These are, I don't have them yet, but now I do. Splinter Cell Double Agent for the PlayStation 2, again, complete, mint shaped discs. Alright, next one up, Lord of the Rings. These are all like five. This, I think, was like $7 complete. But it is complete. Whoever had these would definitely, it was adult owned. One kid owned. Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Didn't have that one yet. Oh, sorry. That is complete as well. Try to get through it pretty quickly. Alright, now we're getting a little bit better. I found a couple Genesis titles. I already have a couple of these, but I couldn't pass it up. Might try to sell it all later on eBay or something, but Sonic the Hedgehog 3, complete, has manual, and a couple of these inserts. I might put one of these, I guess it's the poster or something. Anyway, that's pretty awesome. Again, it's like mint shape. Alright, next one up. Very excited about this one. If I can play it somehow on one of my computers, I don't know. Star Wars Galaxies. You see, I paid $4.25 for that. Oh, and all these games, they didn't have price tags on them. I was a little scared how much they would be, but they all worked for the 2-for-5 deal, so I was very happy. This one, it says loose on price charting, $20, but I don't know. Might see if I can maybe sell it. 2K Sports, Major League Baseball, 2K10. Alright. Complete. Oops. Oh yeah, and that Star Wars Galaxies, it has some tape on it. I'm hoping I'm going to be able to get that off. And probably one of the best finds here, still in shrink wrap, EverQuest Titanium Edition Factory Seal. This is like $40 right here. Awesome finds today, and it is a Sunday. Go figure. All right, till next time, I'm Power Player Paul, and I'll see you later.